They are a divisive, dangerous party, and the choice today for the voter in Bengal is whose idea of the constitution do you want? Have you had 2 days, two phases? Calcutta North will vote on one day, Calcutta South will vote on one day. The districts, you've chopped it up into three different parts. One district with, you might as well have had, I think, Yashwanji, who joined our party recently. I don't know, he said this quite interestingly. He once called me up and said, Derek, I'm going to tweet this. Why are you complaining about eight? We should have 294 phases. That they wanted to have a dead tigress. But now they've got an injured tigress, which is more dangerous than a dead tigress.
Bangla nijer meke chai, which of course stems from the narrative that Mamata Banerjee has been talking about in her campaign rallies about how BJP is an outsider party. Do you think this gives rise to a regionalist mentality, which is something that Trinamool Congress is not necessarily known for?
The worst kind out of all of these, and that I have an ethical issue with, it's got nothing to do with politics. Those unethical, unscrupulous people who were in cahoots with the BJP all these months, and then when the war is announced, that's the time you leave. For them, there is absolutely no sympathy, no pity.
So can you explain to me the role of Abhishek Banerjee in the party?
Six chief ministers are going to come and campaign. 20-25 ministers will come and campaign. They've got all these allies. They've got thousands of troops which they're going to deploy here. They've got all this, all the government agencies. We have one chappal, one woman, and 10 years of hard work. And I think it's good that not only the big television channels, and the media houses who are supine and prostrate in front of this BJP government, there are independent channels like you, and that's why we take off in Trinamool. And I don't want to sound condescending, but to encourage more independent channels, doesn't matter how many viewers you have and how small you are, to spread the message, because eventually in all this, you also need the media with a spine.
Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Epicenter, our video series on the Bengal election, as Bengal right now is the epicenter for all the political action in the country. Today we have Mr. Derek O'Brien with us, who is a member of parliament in the Rajya Sabha for the Trinamool Congress. He's also the party leader in the Rajya Sabha, and he's also the chief national spokesperson for the Trinamool Congress. So he knows one or two things about answering questions. I hope he's going to be candid with us today. So thank you so much for joining us on Epicenter. So I want to start with TMC's campaign slogan, or the election slogan, which says Bangla Nijer Meke Chai, which of course stems from the narrative that Mamata Banerjee has been talking about in her campaign rallies about how BJP is an outsider party. Do you think that it gives, I mean, her whole narrative is about insiders and outsiders and Amra versus Ora. Do you think this gives rise to a regionalist mentality, which is something that Trinamool Congress is not necessarily known for, and even Bengal? What I mean is that Mamata Banerjee has said that all those people who fear persecution under the CA or the NRC are welcome in Bengal. TMC calls itself an inclusive party. It calls itself a tolerant party. Do you think that this goes against Trinamool Congress's stand?
I think you've taken one sentence and you've made a few assumptions, and I'm sorry I'm being blunt but not rude. You shouldn't have come to all those conclusions. Bangla Nijer Meke Chai is one aspect of our campaign. What is the proposition for the voter in Bengal today? It's a very simple proposition that you have voted in my government 10 years ago. I have done this for the last 10 years on health, on education, on road infrastructure, on bringing in investment, on IT, on farmers. All this has been done in the last 10 years. And you have the BJP, who have made a lot of promises in the last 6 or 7 years at the center and have delivered nothing. That is the proposition. Now you come to the second part about a slogan. You see, slogans alone don't win elections. Hard work wins elections. So that's why I made the point of all the good work. You see, I have a list here because I sometimes forget. So I'll read it from here. Number one in MSME, number one in construction of rural houses, construction of rural roads. Who's number one? Bengal is number one, 88,000 kilometers of roads. Skill development, work transparency, ease of doing business. This is all Bengal. Now you come to the line. Listen, whether your name is Agarwal, Sharma, D'Souza, Mukherjee, Bes Barua, all welcome in Bengal. We have, I mean, look at all of us in Bengal. Everybody is welcome. So the outsider, insider, don't get into the trap which the BJP are trying to make an outsider, insider know. What are we saying? We are saying y'all are bloodsuckers, y'all are vote suckers who only come here during elections. To try and say, we will do this, we will do that. We have no problem. Come here, live, vote. We are not at all parochial. Bengal is one of the happy states like that.
That's exactly what I meant.
Yes. So don't get sucked into what the BJP are trying to misrepresent. We are all, with all the different surnames, all in Bengal. We strongly object to those like Modi and Shah who are coming here. They have blood on their hands from 2002 and they're talking about peace. They're going to bring peace in Bengal. They're going to give jobs in Bengal. The same people who offered 1 crore, 2 crore jobs. They're going to make demonetization improve Bengal. Mamata Banerjee called out demonetization within 2 hours. So these are all fake promises that they're making. And they are a divisive, dangerous party. And the choice today for the voter in Bengal is, whose idea of the constitution do you want? Do you want the constitution as the founding fathers, mothers wrote and interpreted? Or do you want Modi Shah's version of the constitution? This is not only a Bengal election. This is actually not even an India election. It's much more beyond that. And that is why there is so much focus here. And I think it's good that not only the big television channels, the big television channels and the media houses who are supine and prostrate in front of this BJP government, there are independent channels like you, and that's why we take off in Trinamool. And I don't want to sound condescending, but to encourage more independent channels, doesn't matter how many viewers you have and how small you are, to spread the message, because eventually in all this you also need the media with a spine.
Yeah, thank you so much for that, sir. So you're saying that this is not regionalism at all?
Listen, of course it's not. I just told you. D'Souza, Agarwal, Sharma, Roy Chaudhary, Huck, Bes Barua, anybody can come, you know. The hospital in the famous hospitals in Calcutta, Bangur Hospital. Who set up Bangur Hospital? Came and the Bangur family of Calcutta. That's only just one example I gave you. They came from Rajasthan. SSKM, Shambhunath Pandit Hospital. Pandit came from outside. They came here. So if you look at the history, the problem is what? Amit Shah, Modi, tourist gang, they have become the great, I call them the tourist gang, but actually they're the great pretenders. You know, these are the people who will come read off a teleprompter and then they'll forget in case the teleprompter doesn't work, and they'll take Rabindranath Tagore and say he was born in Shantiniketan. Then they will tell you that Birsa Munda statue, oh, I garlanded the wrong statue. You know, these are the kind of things. So it's a big fight. And listen, let's not be complacent. Let's not be arrogant, because you're taking on the world's biggest and most destructive force. They have infinity money. They have infinity media backing. They have 3 reliable allies, the CBI, the ED and the IT. They have many institutions. I don't want to go into any abbreviations of those institutions, because then those institutions will get further damaged. So they have all this. They have a 2-month election campaign. I mean, this has never happened in the history of Indian elections. You know, I need to ask, in all humility, ask the election commission. since independence now, one city in India, say Delhi, Calcutta, Mumbai, Madras, wherever, have you had two phases? Calcutta North will vote on one day, Calcutta South will vote on one day. The districts, you've chopped it up into three different parts. One district with, you might as well have had, I think, Yashwanji, who joined our party recently. I don't know, he said this quite interestingly. He once called me up and said, Derek, I'm going to tweet this. Why are you complaining about eight? We should have 294 phases. So these are the kind. Now, you know, you'll say, no. But in 2011, there were seven phases in the Jungle Mahal area. The number of deaths in 2011, when Mamata Banerjee took over for Maoist violence and political killings, was 400 odd. Now that number is zero.
But Election Commission's explanation for this is that it's because of the violence that Bengal sees during the election, during the voting. Because even in 2019, in the seven phases, there were incidents of violence reported in every phase in Bengal. So that's their explanation. Do you think the eight-phase election is a drawback to the TMC?
Not because of the violence. The eight-phase election is a drawback to the TMC for one reason. And I want to be very honest and tell you. The reason is that the longer the election, it's like a longer the interview you make or the longer the edit you have to do, the longer it is, the more money you need. And we don't have the bucks the BJP have. So it's a tough one for us. You see, they've got six chief ministers are going to come and campaign. 20, 25 ministers will come and campaign. They've got all these allies. They've got thousands of troops which they're going to deploy here. They've got all this, all the government agencies. We have one chappal, one woman, and 10 years of hard work. So that's what we're going to the people with. And we're very sure. You see, this tourist gang, AS as in assistant sales manager, he comes and makes predictions in Chhattisgarh, he made some predictions in Delhi, all big talk. You know, we are now, Mamata Di tells us, don't do any big talk. Be humble. And what is our humility? That we haven't done all the work in the last 10 years. How can you do all the work in the last 10 years? That's why in the last 6 months, we came out with this unique initiative, which is the largest, I believe, outreach program in the world. Like the Kanyashri got awarded the United Nations. I think this door-to-door Duare Sarkar will also get an award. What does that do? It reaches out directly and it says, hey, listen, you may not have got your scheduled caste, scheduled tribe certificate. You may not have got your health card, which is unique, 10 crore people. You may not have got something, but hold on. We have the humility 6 months before the polls to come and say that, come, now we will try and get it right. So there is no arrogance. There is, you see, the brazenness and the body language of these, of this campaign. And we have this lady, I think she put it very well. Last week when I met her, she put this very well, that they wanted to have a dead tigress. But now they've got an injured tigress, which is more dangerous than a dead tigress, and I dare say more dangerous than a non-injured tigress. Mamata Banerjee is, and I'm not saying this, I don't need to say this as a sycophant, but as a reality, you have to see the energy, I'm not saying energy of the woman, no, energy of the chief minister. The energy, the passion, the, you know, the clear, the vision and the commitment. And what's in it for her? She's climbed every peak there is to climb, but this one is important, and that's why so many people from across India, they didn't want us to put up the candidates under the symbol. None of these leaders, chief ministers, opposition, none of them said that we want a candidate here. They're just sending us messages, sending Mamata Di messages saying that hang in there, you go, win this for us.
So, but we have to talk about the defections from the TMC to the BJP. There are so many TMC leaders.
Okay, let's play a little quiz now. You give me the name
But there are quite a lot of leaders.
You give me the name.
I don't know the exact number. I was actually trying to find it though. But I think, but there are almost 60 to 70 at least.
60 to 70 what?
Leaders.
Who've left
the TMC.
60 to 70? That's about, that's so much.
I'm not talking about MLAs or...
60 to 70 Trinamool leaders have left Trinamool.
No?
I'm sitting in the Trinamool headquarters here in Calcutta.
So how many are there, sir?
A few MLAs. To give you an idea, we had 211 MLAs. Then we went up to 219 MLAs. Now if you, as in Trinamool MLAs, at 200 and over 200 MLAs. Now let me tell you about each of these. There's in different groups. One, there's a group of five MLAs who left last week. Why did they leave? Because they didn't get tickets in phase 1 and phase 2 or phase 3 or phase 4. So they left. Five MLAs left. Okay. Before that, two ministers left. The two ministers are standing in their own seats. One is standing from Nandigram. The other is standing from Howrah and Dumjur. They are standing. Na? Let them win their seats. So what are we talking about? Now, we have this line called Khala Hobe. Match on. If Trinamool had quote unquote so many defections, then why isn't BJP the world's largest, most destructive party? Why aren't they announcing their list of 294? What's holding them back? Trinamool is a small regional party. We are only the third largest party after BJP and Congress. We've announced 291 candidates in one go. Fact? We've left three in the hills.
Yeah.
BJP, phase one, phase two, they couldn't even announce full list then. Now, phase three, phase four, they couldn't even announce then. Now we are still left to announce 5, 6, 7, 8. So you, I don't know when your program is being telecast, but you watch the fun. Every time they announce a list, there's going to be more and more of the SXXX hitting the fan.
But sir, why are these defections happening? TMC will have to... No, but TMC will have to admit that it can't only be about power, money, opportunity.
Let me give you the names. Five, why did they defect? Five MLAs defected. You didn't get a ticket, you defected. What can I do? What can anybody do? They did not get a ticket.
Why did Shuvendu Adhikari defect?
You mentioned the MLA from Nandigram. I have a counter question to you. For 9.5 years, Trinamool Congress was great. You had the milk, you had the cream, you had three ministries, you had everything. Suddenly now, between 4-5 months before the elections, everything is wrong about the Trinamool Congress. Why did you leave now? Number two, your home seat is Nandigram. Fight from Nandigram and win the seat.
That's what he's doing.
No, he's doing the first part. He has to do the second part. That's what he's doing, I don't know. The candidate list was first put out by Trinamool Congress. He's chasing our, BJP is chasing our narrative. You tell me, you're talking about Trinamool. Why don't I put a counter question? Where are the BJP MLA candidates? This is a new one. A tourism minister is coming to fight in an MLA seat. Not tourism, sorry. I think environment minister of state. Coming to fight an MLA seat. Four other MPs are coming to fight MLA seats. What does that mean? It means you don't have the people. You're demoting your MPs and getting them to fight. You're creating a gas balloon which you've created with the help of a few pliant, supine, those who prostrate media. But you don't have the hawa. And you ask me? We're not talking about... Have you seen yesterday they announced list number 3 or 4? You're an independent journalist. Please go to the BJP head office at Hastings or go anywhere else and you see Khala Hobe, the match is on, the games are on. Why? Because there are three BJPs. You also know there are three BJPs in Bengal. There is the original BJP of Bengal, headed by one RSS hardcore. I may disagree with his ideology, but at least I have to give him this much credit. He hasn't been a turncoat. He hasn't jumped the boat. That's one.
The second. Are you talking about Dilip Ghosh?
I never like to mention names because that is better you do and you've done it. The second one is the guys who came 4-5 years ago. And one out-of-work politician from Madhya Pradesh, he had to be accommodated somewhere, so they told him, go take a hotel and live in Calcutta. Okay. Here also, I want to give him credit. At least he came here often enough.
Kailash Vijayvargiya.
That's the name you said. That's the second BJP. And the third BJP is what I call the Trinamool C BJP B. So Trinamool C team and the these people, no, some of them were ministers. As I said, they had all the perks of government, and then suddenly 6 months before, but the worst kind out of all of these, and that I have an ethical issue with. It's got nothing to do with politics. Those unethical, unscrupulous people who were in cahoots with the BJP all these months, and then when the war is announced, that's the time you leave. For them, there is absolutely no sympathy, no pity.
So when Dinesh Trivedi left, he said, and I'm quoting here, he said that there is rampant corruption in Trinamool Congress. He said that Trinamool Congress, which was once a democratic setup, has become completely authoritarian, and the power structure is under Mamata Banerjee and Abhishek Banerjee. So how much truth is there to this statement?
My parents always taught me three lines. Great people talk about ideas. Good people talk about events. Great people talk about ideas. Good people talk about events. Small people talk about other people.
That's
enough said.
So can you explain to me the role of Abhishek Banerjee in the party? That has been a bone of contention amongst many TMC leaders. His rise in influence has created some sort of an upheaval amongst the TMC leaders. Can you explain to me his role?
That's a good question. So let's start with, I don't want to go pre his electoral career, because he can't change that. He was born into a political family. He was born into Mamata Banerjee's family. Nobody in her family is in joined politics. And the stories we hear, as a child, he would go around with a Congress flag at that time, wondering why his aunt was getting bashed up. So in 2014, strong buzz that he was going to get the South Calcutta seat, which was Mamata Di's home seat, and here was the lollipop gift coming. But he didn't get that seat. He was instead given Diamond Harbour. 75,000 votes. He won that seat in 2014. He became a first-time MP. For those 5 years, I also would ask him. I said, you don't come to Parliament very often. Mm-hmm. When you do take part in debates, you make good speeches, but you're not into the Delhi media. Would you want to do interviews? He's told me, said, no. I have only one job. Only one job. From 2009 to 2014 to 2019, I want to take care of this parliamentary constituency called Diamond Harbour. I want to touch people's lives. Health, water, roads, education, everything. So he did that work for 5 years, only in Diamond Harbour. Mm. What happened? 2019. He could have been voted out.
He won again.
He not just won again. He didn't win by 75,000 votes like he did in 2014. He didn't win by 1 lakh votes. He didn't win by 2 lakh votes. He didn't win by 3 lakh votes. He won by 3.5 or 3,30,000 votes. So this is a young lad who's worked hard in his constituency, and sheer hard work, he got a reward of 3,30,000. What's anybody's problem with him? What's anybody's problem? And look who can talk about dynasty. BJP. They have the worst track record of dynasty. They have the worst track record. I don't ever mention people's names in interviews, because I think politics is about policy. Politics is about ideology. Politics is not about just throwing names of people. You asked me so much about just now, you asked me about the MLA from Nandigram. That dynasty is okay, is it? Daddy is an MP, younger brother is an MP, other brother is an MP, and the fourth brother is the chairman of a municipality, and between them they have 20-25 posts. That's okay. When a former BJP MP's son becomes a minister, that's okay. A chief minister, that's okay. So BJP make their own rules. Okay. And I don't want to get into this, you know, this. So this is the story of Abhishek Banerjee. This is the story, of course. Is he a political, strong political force in Bengal? Yes. In Diamond Harbour? Yes. Is he adding value to the party? He doesn't need certificate from me or anybody. I've given you the story. Mm. From 70,000 votes, he's gone to 330,000 votes and he has a role to play in the party.
So why has this narrative of him being a tolabaj come into the mainstream now? Why is everybody calling him a tolabaj?
Don't you understand? Please see a film called The Social Network.
I've seen it.
You've seen it? You liked it?
Yeah.
So this is the fabulous story where the BJP and their devious IT communication network and cell, if you want to call them, headed by Amit Shah. And I say this because Amit Shah, you don't remember, and if during my interview I'll only make one request to you, try and find the one clip, I'll give it to you, where Mr. Amit Shah says on record, main sach ko jhoot kar dunga aur jhoot ka sach, kyunki hamare paas 41 us samay WhatsApp group hai, main dikhaunga jo Akhilesh ji thappar mara Mulayam Singh ji ko, wo fake news, sach ke jhoot. So BJP have that knack. They create a papu. And they create that. So they create a tolaba. These are created 1 or 2 years before any election. This is their way of building perception, false perception. Hmm. Should I start telling you about Mr. Jai Shah? Please look at his company and how much percent of his company net worth went. We don't get into this. He's an honorable young man. Let him do his thing.
So let's talk about Prashant Kishore's involvement in the TMC right now. That is another thing that a lot of TMC leaders do have an issue with. People are saying that his involvement, it's exceeding campaign strategizing, and it's actually, he is involved in day-to-day activities of the TMC as well.
Well, this is the Trinamool headquarters, and at least, you know, we take questions. All questions. Did you give me any of these questions in advance?
No.
You just came here asking me all the difficult questions. I'll happy. At least you all should all try, independent journalists or non-independent journalists, to try and do an interview like this with the great man with the beard. When in 2014, when the Gujarat chief minister hired Prashant Kishore, nobody had a problem. Nobody had a problem. We are a political party. They add value. They collaborate with us. They partner us. So when you have a partnership, and their contract is till the middle of May, once Mamta Di gets sworn in, Mamta Banerjee 3.0, that's it with IPAC for the moment. Now, in any organization, if you bring in an outside agency, of course there is going to be some upheaval, especially if a boy or a girl is between the age of 18 and 25. I have a daughter, 25. So we are a 22-year, 23-year-old organization. So the same thing which happens in a 20, 23-year-old organization, you get used to a little bit of, you know. So I do believe that if you have to take this election machinery on, you need certain inputs. The party is run by the chairperson, Ms. Mamata Banerjee, and we have a working committee, All India Working Committee. I'm happy to inform you that Yashwant Sinha ji has recently been inducted into that working committee. Yes. You have a party of 220 MLAs, 35 MPs, couple of thousand councillors. There will be a 5-10%, you know, I better not start telling you about what I discuss in Central Hall with the BJP MPs. Forget about the MPs. Imagine if what is discussed in Central Hall stays in Central Hall. If I start telling you what some of those leaders think about Mr. Modi and Mr. Shah, you know, that won't be nice. It won't also be proper on my part, because those are private conversations. So,
So a lot of political pundits, political commentators at one point were saying that to make sure that BJP does not come to power in Bengal, TMC should ally with the left and the Congress in the state. Why didn't the TMC feel the need to do that?
We are a political party who believed that we've done 10 years of work and our ideology obviously is closer to the Congress ideology because we were originally, Mamta Di was originally with the Congress. But there's no question of having a tie-up. A tie-up means it has to be win-win for both of us. So now that's history. It wasn't a situation where we were in a win-win-win-win for us and win-win-win-win for them. But since you asked me this question, let me tell you something interesting. That since independence, there are very few, rare, actually nobody who has left the Congress party and subsequently run a government for 2 terms. What happens when you leave the Congress, as Mamta Di did in 1997? Mamta Di didn't leave the Congress. She was shunted out of the Congress because she thought the Congress was in cahoots with the CPM. She was not Nostradamus, but now I have to call her Nostradamus Banerjee. Exactly, otherwise they would never have been thrown out. So she had a good reason. So anybody who leaves, what happens? You either get subsumed by the Congress party, or you leave politics, or you go and join another party, or in some cases, like Mr. Pawar in Maharashtra, you have a coalition government with the Congress. You name me one person since independence, quiz question, who has run 2 governments after leading the Congress.
So let's talk about the 3 seats that the TMC has left for the Gorkha Janamukti Morcha in the Darjeeling Hills. Now,
We have not said anything. We have just left 3 seats there. So we have just left 3 seats there.
For the JJM, no?
We haven't said anything. Did you see the press conference of the Chief Minister? She didn't say anything. She just said we are announcing 291 seats and we are not announcing the 3 seats in the hills.
But JJM is the ally of the TMC this time.
She did not say anything like this in the press conference. So.
But the divide in the Gorkha Janamukti Morcha, do you think that this is a big drawback for the TMC because all the anti-BJP votes are going to get completely divided?
So that's your interpretation. There again, when Mamta Di took over in 2011, what was the state of Jungle Mahal? What was the state of the hills? And see how things have improved. Surely with development, see when you make a card, the health card, which is the blue card. It doesn't matter whether you're from the hills, whether you're Adivasi, whether you're Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe, Hindu, Muslim, Christian. It's for everybody.
आप ये कह रहे हो कि hills में कोई भी fight करे इसमें TMC को वो नहीं है.
What is it?
मतलब because it is a seat that TMC has been losing every single time that they've contested from. So are you saying that they don't care about who fights on these seats?
We want the people of the hills to express themselves. And in whichever way they express themselves, we will humbly bow down and say, okay, this is your expression. We will carry on doing what we do. I don't think, let's not in the middle of March start now thinking about May the 2nd. You can be rest assured of one thing. Mamata Banerjee will be the Chief Minister of Bengal, without a doubt.
So my last question and building up on
We are actually finishing this interview. This is like a marathon, marathon interview. This is almost now like a Satyajit Ray film.
Last question.
No problem.
Just
no problem.
Building up on what
as
you
said. As I said, these are platforms which need to be encouraged, not only by Trinamool, but by everybody else, because there are young people who are trying to save this constitution.
So do you think that Bengal politics has become overtly communal? I asked the same question to Dilip Ghosh a few days ago and he said that yes, it has, but he said that it has always been and it is not BJP's doing. He said that if Mamata Banerjee was indulging in minority appeasement or minority communalism, the opposite is happening now and that is what is coming to the forefront. But Bengal has always been communal is what he said. How would you respond to that?
I don't want to respond to him because you check out what my colleague Dr. Kakuli Ghosh Dostidar responded to him when he said terrible things about Ma Durga. How do you respond to people who desecrate the statue of Ishwar Chandra Bidyasagar? How do you respond? you know, this kind of his understanding of Bengal, his understanding of Bengal and Bengal's understanding of Bengal are two completely different views. His understanding, the BJP and the RSS's understanding of the, and the ideologues, Gowarkar, Savarkar, these are, what is their understanding of the freedom movement? So I don't want to get into a debate like that, because it's a no-brainer kind of debate.
But do you think politics has become communal? Do you think?
No, I don't think so. Till Mamata Banerjee is here, God forbid the day the Trinamool is not here, then it's not. There's only peace, harmony, development. These are the stories which are Bengal is proud of. Culture, art, peace, harmony, everything. Everything is like this. You know, I grew up in Jamir Lane here in Baliganj in Calcutta. My daughter is a Chindu. She's a Christian Hindu. She goes to the temple. She goes to the church. Her best friend one of her best friend is Muslim. What is this? Where are we coming to? What is this? Not about Bengal. What is this India we are talking about? That's what I'm saying. This is not a Bengal election. This is not a India election. This is the world is looking at this election. Vajpayee's BJP. Yashwanji was telling me this beautiful story. He said Vajpayee's BJP was of consensus. This BJP of Modi and Shah is of conquest. Conquest at any cost. We have to conquer. We have to capture.
Sir, thank you so much for talking to us. Thank you very, very much.
Pleasure.
If you like this video, don't forget to virtually like this video as well. Share the video with your friends and your followers. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon so you do not miss an update every time we upload a new video. Support this channel to encourage independent journalism in the country. Thank you so much for watching.